Okay, remember that video I did a couple of years ago where I planted the tomatoes all along the fence row? I believe they call it a Kentucky weave, where you weave them in and out of the fence or something that way rather than growing that way. Well, I have just planted, like I said, my greenhouse is going to be empty whenever we go back in there again because I have just planted a bunch of tomatoes along the fence. Let me show you what's going on. Okay, this is what I call the plum guild. And right here, what I have planted is some, well, we've got purslane along the front here, and these did grow in the greenhouse. And then what we have here, we have marigolds, so the short type. Marigold, marigold, marigolds, that triangle, right? Marigold, marigold, marigold. And in between, because marigold is a fumigant, is all cauliflower in here. Rather than having a row of cauliflower, I do have them en masse, but these marigolds in the back, so this is one little, what, 3 or 4 square feet? Probably a yard. These are the crackerjack marigolds. So these are the dwarf, like French type, and then this is the crackerjack. So, and the crackerjacks will be big in the back, kind of outlining that. And then we have the shorter marigolds kind of in between with the cauliflower. And then when this fills in, you won't be able to see any soil in between. And then this sage plant was already there, so I had to really cut it back because of the drought we had last year. Okay, so then these are the plum trees right here. Let me step on the path. And there's plums all over the plum trees. They're just everywhere. And yes, I do see little plums on the ground all the time. They just don't make it. But you know what? The wind thins my fruit for me. Now I need to come in here and do some stuff in here. But these are the tomatoes that I am about to plant on this fence line. And yes, there's grapes growing here, but I'm just going to train the tomatoes to go up in between and all around all of this. So there's more plums. This is a different variety. I think this is the purple one. This is the pomegranate tree. This is where the tomatoes are going to be growing. I did this fence the last couple of days. So what I have done here, and I've got this irrigation hose where it has these little holes. Let's see, there's a tomato right there. So tomato, tomato, basil. So again, it's kind of that alternating pattern, right? It's tomato, basil, tomato, basil. It kind of looks like a graph, like an EKG, you know, that's going sideways. But all, so that's basil, tomato, basil, tomato, basil, tomato, basil, tomato. And it's all down that fence line. So I do have grapes, like I said, growing on this fence. This is an old, old fence, but I've done this several times. And I'll just weave the plant. It's not really a vine, but it grows like a vine. They're indeterminate. I will just weave the tomatoes in and out. And again, I'll try to find a snippet of that video showing. This is a combination of San Marzano, Jubilee, Cherokee, all along here. So this is where I'm going to be growing tomatoes, all up and down this fence line right here. So I have stepped back out, and if you'll remember from past videos, this is where we used to have pear trees. I killed them. It was my fault. It's a long story. Anyway, we have sage growing here, but we did plant the two olive trees right here. And then we have catnip. We have a few weeds growing in here, but I am going to be doing something with this wild lettuce. We've got another sage plant here. And then we've got, and here I am stepping in front, kind of from the back side of where all these tomatoes are. So let me go back out. And then these are all of the, this is what I picked for a bouquet for Mother's Day, is the larkspur. And that's about to be done. So as soon as that's done, and then this plantain, I've been harvesting plantain like crazy. We've got some oregano in there. But as soon as I'm pulling this out, I'm gonna be putting something else in. Again, it's kind of that shift or succession planting. It's not really succession planting, but let's see what else we have going on here. We've got a lot of blue bonnets in there. I'm waiting for those seeds to be ready. Let's see. They're starting to turn brown, the pods. But when I start to see these pods burst open, I'm going to be collecting all of these and I'm going to be doing something else with them. We've got a lot of cilantro in here. We have some newly planted gomphrena. Oh, so here's where I have, well, there's cannas. I have artichokes. Artichoke, artichoke, artichoke. Again, in that triangle pattern with the short dwarf marigolds in between, and then the tall crackerjack marigolds in the back. So kind of a little keyhole planting within a planting. And then here we have peppers, sweet peas, peppers, more the short type. Of course, I didn't want to put the tall type, because they'll get about this big, but I'm going to be planting a tomato or a cucumber on the other side of that trellis, because this is one of those things that cannot take the heat. So when it's done, it'll be coming out, and then want to use this vertical space for something else. The reason I have that on there is, I don't know, I have these baskets and I saw that something was kind of munching on this, and until that gets big enough, that's one of my artichoke plants. It was a lot bigger, like this one. But until that kind of gets reestablished, I'm just gonna protect it a little bit. Now, I had a problem. I planted some beans here before, some green beans, some bush type beans. This is on the back side of this trellis. And they didn't grow. I forgot they were there and I didn't water them. But in some other places, I had some cutworms. And you can go look at videos on cutworms, but I replanted these bush beans here, and I'm gonna be replanting some more, but the cutworms got them, so that happens sometimes. But I did plant the tall variety of the crackerjack marigolds in the back. Back out now. Sorry about the hose, it's kind of distracting, that white hose. By the way, did you know if you go to the RV section, the hoses are cheaper? Anyway, I planted that tall marigold in the back so it would show through that trellis. So I can't wait to see what that looks like. I don't usually do the same thing every year in the same place. I kind of mix it up. It's kind of like painting with plants, right? It's a chance for me to be creative. So now, one of the things that I am hoping is that whenever I have planted marigolds, that leaf is kind of broken. Whenever I planted any type of marigolds, they self-seed very readily. So I'm hoping that they're going to self-seed like all of these larkspur and that cilantro and some of these, the blue bonnets and some of these other things have done, because it'll be fine with me if... It'll be fine with me if these want to drop their seeds and come back here in the same spot every year. Just like what happened right here. So last year I had, I'm across the bed in another bed right now, but these bachelor buttons just came up on their own. They are not a perennial plant. They just self-seeded, and that's fine with me. Anytime anything wants to self-seed, like here, we need to mow. But this cilantro plant is self-seeded in the grass. Oh, well, it's fine. You know, whenever it's time to mow, it just kind of smells like salsa. But yeah, so I'm hoping that here's the place where I planted some more bush beans, And then this is some buckwheat, which this is my first year to grow. Aren't they pretty though? Very pretty. But I'm hoping that these are gonna self-seed. That'd be fine with me if they self-seed here every year. That'd be okay. I'm hoping they're gonna bush out a little bit. I'm hoping I didn't plant them too far apart my first time to grow these. Passion fruit coming up everywhere. Passion fruit vine coming up everywhere. This is some forsythia. Ooh. See, I just don't worry about it when I see bugs in the garden because I know they're going to be preyed upon. Let's see. What else? We have some peanuts. Oh, gosh. Growing here. Oregano. Some lantana, nephrophia. So this is this bed that's across from this bed. Forgive my pile, I need to mow. the pomegranate trees. And I'm sorry, y'all missed the show. The irises are done. They were so beautiful. I don't even think I got a picture. But yeah, they were just big and purple and beautiful. And so, and then we're back to the plum trees again. Let's see. Bush beans up in there. So I need to finish planting those tomatoes. But that is zone two. I call it the plum guild. I used to have, I'll tell you what happened. Okay, so with the cherry trees and the pear trees that we had, I made a big mistake with soaker hoses. So the soaker hoses got a leak in them. Let me show you one right here, okay? But it was buried under the ground. And I don't know if you've ever experienced this or not, but they'll get a nick or a hole in them, or they wear down, and then they'll just be like, psh, like a what do you call it? Laser, where you know you could drill a hole with it. Well, it drilled a hole in the soil right under the roots of the trees, and there was just a big cavern there. So there was just air exposed to the roots, so I will be more careful with that next time. All right, that's gonna do it for this one. Until next time, bye for now. Oh, don't forget to hit subscribe, the thumbs up button if you liked it, and if you know someone who's really into it, share it with them. Edible landscaping, talk to you guys later. Bye for now.